With only four main ingredients, malted barley, hops, yeast, and water, it's surprising how many styles and variations there are of beer in the world. It's also hotly contested how many styles or how to divide them. But there's one thing that everybody can agree on, and that is that beers are really separated by the yeast type into two categories, ales and lagers. Ales are the longer, older component of beer. Ales have been around for thousands and thousands of years and was the focus of most of the development of beer up until the last 200 years. Ales use a top fermenting yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, beer. The other type, lagers, are a bottom fermenting yeast, Saccharomyces pastureanus. Turns out that there's several names for this yeast, and sometimes that gets confusing. But what we do know about lager yeast is a bottom fermenting yeast, and really did not come around until the last 200 years, mainly because bottom fermenting yeast, the lager yeast, use lower temperatures. So therefore, the lower temperature was only available during the winters or in caves until modern refrigeration. If we look at these two types of beer, we can compare them to wine, red wine and white wine. Ales are more like red wines. They're going to have a more complex flavor palette, and they also will be things that are less crisp, but that have a lot of body. Like white wines, lagers are crisp and refreshing, but they won't have as complex of a taste profile. Now, making ales can be done any time of the year, and we're really looking at temperatures in the 65 Fahrenheit to 75 Fahrenheit range. With lagers, we're really looking on the colder range, 40 to 55 degrees Fahrenheit. Lagers have become very popular over the last 200 years. If we think about the types of beers that are consumed the most in America, lager styles are the types that Americans are known for drinking. But it's also where the manufacture of lagers really took off, where the manufacturing and industrial base allowed for both refrigeration to help in the fermentation process, but also refrigeration to stabilize those lagers so they could be transported and consumed in large regions. It turns out that this is very region. So if we think about wine, we have regions of wines. We have descriptions of wines in France that are very regional based. We can use the same type of regional base to describe beers. Therefore, you often will see styles of beers broken into the different regions. You will see the same terminology used for different regions. You can have a English pale ale, an American pale ale, a German pale ale. Just like with the wine regions, there's slight variations of these, but they're all pale ales. The other things that we can use for different styles is color, bitterness, the gravity, which often gives us the alcohol content, and the aroma. For this course, we're going to use a very simplistic view of the styles of ales and lagers. Again, if there's one type of style that you really like, please expand upon that and learn as much as you can around that style. For our ales, we have pale ales, Indian pale ales, brown ales, porters, stouts, barley wine, and wheat beer. For lagers, we have pale lagers, often referred to as Pilsner, Bock's, Dunkel's, and Oktoberfest or Märzen beers, March beer. As I said, we're going to use this basic list of styles for this course, but they diverge greatly. Just like with wine, where that winemaker can take different styles of grapes, but also processes. In beer, there's small variations that can be made with the malted barley, how it's kilned, what temperature it's kilned at, how we do the mashing process, what temperature we're doing our mashing at, how we bring in our different types of hops, when the hops is brought into the process. Although there's two main types of yeast, ale and lager yeast, there are multiple variations of these yeast, often closely held secrets within a brewery that can make a very specific flavor palette. And then finally, how we finish that beer. All of this goes in to make the rich variety of beers we have in the world.